like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the sunlit from heaven, like the first dewfall on the first grass. Praise for the sweetness of the wet garden, sprung in completeness where his feet. Mine is a sunlight, mine is a morning, born of the one light, Eden's all play. Praise with elation, praise every morning, God's recreation.
Son, and the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Friends, we're honored today to be joined by Father Cosmas Mabu, who today is saying Mass in his intention for his mother, whose funeral was this morning in Nigeria. We also celebrate a Saints' Day today, St. Martin de Porres. We have saints here today after Mass. Let's reflect on our own journey of becoming saints, of becoming like Christ in our generosity to others. Let's reflect on the times when we withheld ourselves, preparing ourselves to celebrate these holy mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison. And let us pray. O God, who led St. Martin de Porres by the path of humility to heavenly glory, grant that we may so follow his radiant example in this life as to merit to be exalted with him in heaven forever. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, owe nothing to anyone except to love one another. For the one who loves another has fulfilled the law, the commandments. You shall not commit adultery, you shall not kill, you shall not steal, you shall not covet. And whatever other commandment there may be are summed up in this saying, namely, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Love does no evil to the neighbor, hence, love is the fulfillment of the law. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response is, blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need. Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need. Blessed the man who fears the Lord, who greatly delights in his commands. His posterity shall be mighty upon the earth. The upright generation shall be blessed. Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need. He dawns through the darkness, a light for the upright. He is gracious and merciful and just. Well for the man who is gracious and lends, who conducts his affairs with justice. Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need. Lavishly he gives to the poor. His generosity shall endure forever. His horn shall be exalted in glory. Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Great crowds were traveling with Jesus, and he turned and addressed them. If anyone comes to me without hating his mother and father, wife and children, brothers and sisters, and even his own life, he cannot be my disciple. Whoever does not carry his own cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. Which of you wishing to construct a tower does not first sit down and calculate the cost to see if there is enough for its completion? Otherwise, after laying the foundation and finding himself unable to finish the work, the onlookers should laugh at him and say, "This one began to build, but did not have the resources to finish." Or what king, marching into battle, would not first sit down and decide whether with 10,000 troops he can successfully oppose another king advancing upon him with 20,000 troops? But if not, while he is still far away, he will send a delegation to ask for peace terms. In the same way, every one of you who does not renounce all his possessions cannot be my disciple. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. So kids, how many of you 7th and 8th graders know what Venmo is? Pretty much everybody. Everyone else, Venmo, if you don't know, I just learned about it. It's an online app that lets you pay money to each other, right? You pay people back. My nephews and I go and we'll play golf, and they'll say, "Uncle Tom, I'll pay you back for the tee time, but I'll do it on Venmo." And I said, "What is that?" So I downloaded the app, set it up, and boom, with a click, suddenly, they can pay me back what I owe them. I can pay them if I wanted to treat them to dinner or something like that when they're out with their friends. It's a really cool way to pay people back. I mentioned that today, kids. Why? Our first reading. What did it say? It said that we all owe something to every other human being in the entire world. You, I, everyone here owes a debt to every other person in the whole world, whether we've ever met them or know of them. How can that be? That is what the Bible says is our debt, what we owe to love other people in the same way that God in Christ loved us. It is an obligation. It is our responsibility. It is not something that's nice to do. We don't love because we're kind, we're sweet, we're good people. All those things follow. When you realize, as St. Paul said in the gospel, that the love of God has been poured where? Into your hearts. Then you owe that love to other people. Why would we do that? Because they too, like you and me and every other person from before all time to eternity, was created by that God. And therefore, he is our common father, and therefore, every other human being on earth is our brother and sister in God. And we are required to respect them, to show them courtesy and dignity and love. The love of God has been poured into your hearts so you can become love and justice and inclusion and tolerance and equity and goodness for all people because we have the same parent. The saint that we celebrate today, and I can't wait to learn more about the saints that you have developed here today and your characters. St. Martin de Porres. Is there a St. Martin de Porres over here? Excellent. You can finish this sermon, St. Martin. You want to come up here? I'll help. I'll set you up. How's that? Good? So St. Martin de Porres, sitting right here in our midst, was a 16th century son of a very wealthy Spanish businessman and a slave from Honduras. He grew up in Lima, Peru, and he discovered the love of God had been poured into his heart, and he saw that in every suffering person in the slums of Lima, Peru. And he, St. Martin de Torres, the Porres, gave himself over to serve them. He went to medical school, he studied the healing arts, and he joined the Dominican Order. And for his entire adult life, he spent, count them, 8 hours a day praying in front of the Eucharist at the table, the altar of God. Why would he do that? Because this is the place on earth where the love of God has been poured into our hearts. And it is represented for us at this gift of Jesus himself at the Mass, fulfilled in our hearing, which is why we're here today commemorating St. Martin de Porres. He received the love of God in the great gift of Jesus' self-offering at Calvary, and then he was able to serve, to love, without counting the cost. So kids, today, let's remember, we owe people. We owe them dignity. We owe them respect. Not because they like us, or we like them, or they're nice people, or we're nice people. That's the way the world thinks. We owe them respect because we have the same Father, and they're our brothers and sisters. And out of love for them, we become the love that God has given us. St. Martin de Porres, show us the way to make a gift of ourselves in love and mercy to justice of all persons because we owe it to them. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Let's now bring before the Lord our prayers as may be best for us, for our school and parish's mission to draw all to the love of God.
For all of us in the church, may the Lord bless and purify our hearts for the coming of the fullness of the kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all public authorities, may God grant them humility to be guided by his word. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those experiencing rifts within their families, may the God of peace guide them into reconciliation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For members of this faith community, as we serve one another, may God strengthen our faith through his word and the sacraments. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, especially Beatrice Mebu, mother of Father Cosmos, may our loving Father welcome them into his heavenly kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Teresa Tran, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father, you created us. You fill us with your love and ask us to become love to others. Help us do that through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen.
Our hymn is number 602, I Have Loved You, number 602.
I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you and you are mine. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you and you are mine. Seek the face of the Lord and long for him. He will bring you his light and his peace. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you and you are mine. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you and you are mine. Seek the face of the Lord. Love. I have called you and you are mine. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you and you are mine.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Most merciful Father, who were pleased to create in blessed Saint Martin Porres the new man in your image, the old having passed away, graciously grant, we pray, that renewed like St. Martin, we may offer you an acceptable sacrifice of love through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure, visible signs of your love. and that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled. Their example lends us courage. Their prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same spirits, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with Saint Martin Porres and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Dennis, our Archbishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the words, and my soul shall be healed. O Lord, it is you who are my portion, you yourself who secures my future. Thank you. And let us pray. Renewed, O Lords, at the wellsprings of salvation, we humbly entreat you that through the intercession of blessed St. Martin Porres, holding more closely day by day to Jesus Christ, we may merit to be co-heirs in his kingdom of grace, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Father Cosmos, great to see you again. Prayers and condolences on your mother's mass today. Shout out to Eris and Jocelyn for being our servers, and a special shout out and maybe a round of applause to our very own Martin de Pura. Make it a great day, everyone. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our reception was number 477. Soon and heresy, number
good morning and welcome. Today we are pleased to present our fifth graders who will be sharing their saints' reports with all of you. At this time I'd like to introduce Mrs. Laurie Sullivan to introduce her class.
Good morning. The fifth grade class has been researching and learning about the saints of our Catholic Church. To end our Mass celebration today, we'd like to share with you some of what we've learned. Each student is representing one of our saints and how they are dressed and by what they will say. We ask that all applause be held to all of the students who have had a chance to present their information. We will begin with a special prayer in honor of our beloved saints. Glorious God, during November, we give thanks for our many blessings. Help us to recognize them in our homes, our country, and our world. We especially thank you for our Catholic saints and the great lives they have led. We ask you to help us follow them and become saints ourselves through service and prayer. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
am Saint Joan of Arc. I'm the patron saint of France and members of the military. My feast day is May 30th. I was named a saint because of my bravery and trust in God. I once said, I place my trust in God, my creator, in all things. I love him with all my heart.
I am Saint Josephine Bakita. I am the patron saint of racial discrimination. My feast day is February 8th. I was named a saint because of my bravery and kindness towards others and for serving the poor. I once said, the Lord has loved me so much, we must love everyone. We must be compassionate.
I am Saint Paul. I am the patron saint of missionaries, evangelists, and writers. My feast day is on June 29th. I believe if God is for us, who can be against us?
I am Saint Angela Marisi. I am the patron saint of sickness, disabled, and physically challenged people, and those suffering the loss of parents. My feast day is January 27th. I once said, we will accomplish more by kind words and courteous manner than by anger.
I am Saint Felicity. I am the patron saint of widows and mothers. My feast day is March 7th. I was named a saint because of my bravery and courage. I was put to death because of my faith in Jesus.
I am Saint Dominic Savio. I am the patron saint of choir boys. My feast day is May 6. I once said, I am not capable of doing big things, but I want to do everything, even the smallest things, for the greater glory of God.
I am Saint Luke. I am the patron saint of physicians, glassworkers, butchers, and many more. My feast day is October 18th. I once said, but I say to you, whoever is your enemy, love them, and for nothing will be impossible with God.
I am Saint Francis of Assisi. I am the patron saint of animals and ecology. My feast day is October the 4th. I believe you should start by doing what's necessary, then do what's possible, and all suddenly you are doing the impossible.
I am Saint Maria Goretti. I am the patron saint of teenage girls and Catholic youth. My feast day is July 6. I was a martyr because I promised to be pure to God, to be pure for God. I used to say, he loves, he hopes, he waits. Our Lord prefers to wait himself for the sinner for years rather than keep us waiting an instant.
I am Saint Ignatius of Loyola. I am the patron saint of soldiers. My feast day is July 31st. I founded the Society of Jesus with 6 others. We are also known as the Jesuits. I try to find God in all things. I try to do everything for the greater glory of God.
I am Saint Ambrose, also known as the Honey Tongue Doctor. I am the patron saint of beekeeping. My feast day is December 7th. I once said it's not enough to wish well, but to do well. And in some causes, silence is dangerous.
I am Saint Martin de Porres. I am the patron saint of barbers, the poor, and many more. My feast day is November 3rd. I founded an orphanage for children and slaves. I gave unconditional care of all people, regardless of race or wealth. I once said, compassion, my dear brother, is preferable to cleanliness.
I I am Saint Teresa of Lisieux. I am the patron saint of florists, priests, and the sick. My feast day is October 3rd. I called my great confidence in God the little way. I believe that we should do little things like not complaining and serving others.
Please give a round of applause to our fifth graders. Thank you for coming.